In this skeleton example, I'm going to create a subassembly and a skeleton in the subassembly that contains reference geometry from the top level assembly. To create my subassembly, I will use the create command in the ribbon, and in the create component dialog box, I'll change the radio button from part to subassembly, and this particular subassembly is going to be used for cabling. I will click OK, and then in the creation options dialog box, probably 99% of the time I use the default method copy from existing, and it's got my standard start part listed. I'll click the OK button, and then I'll just drop my subassembly somewhere on the screen. If I hold down the right mouse button, I can get to the default constraint to locate it at the origin of my top level assembly, and then I'll click the check mark to complete placement. You could also use the middle mouse button for doing that. Now when I scroll down to the bottom of my model tree, I see the subassembly that I just created. To create a skeleton inside of it, I will click on it and then use the activate icon. And now when I click the create button, I'll change the type from subassembly to skeleton model. I'm going to leave the default name. Now I'll click OK. And for my creation option, I'm going to use copy from existing and use my standard start part. Now when I expand the subassembly, I see the skeleton model. Let's click on the skeleton and then activate it. And to reference all the geometry in this top level assembly, I'm going to use the shrinkwrap feature. And I'm going to change the method from outer shell to auto collect all solid surfaces. I just want to make sure I get everything. It asks me if I want to exclude internal components. I don't think I have any, but I'm going to click no. If I want to cut down on the number of components that I am shrink wrapping, I can use the subset button. For example, there are some fasteners in here that I might not care about, so I'm going to select them using the shift key and then right click, and I can choose to ignore them. I'll click open to finish selecting components. And one other thing is that there is a references tab on here, and I'm using the auto collect all solid surfaces, so the collector for always include surfaces is not available, but I could select any surfaces that I definitely don't want in the shrink wrap, or I could add edge chains, but I have some datum points and some coordinate systems I might want to reference in my subassembly skeleton. So you can click in the collector for include datums and be aware that that is also available from the right mouse button. And now when I hold down the control key, I can select any of those datum features like datum points or datum coordinate systems that I want to make sure that I get in my shrink wrap feature in the skeleton. All right, from the options tab, this is where you can change your update control. So I have it set to automatic update. That way, if the VCR gets some components added or deleted, when I update my shrink wrap, it'll reflect those changes. And I always like to change the name of my shrink wrap feature to indicate the model that it came from, just because it can help with any problems I have later on with external references if something ends up failing or I end up somehow losing a model or something. All right, let's hit the check mark in order to complete the shrink wrap feature. Right now it's calculating. And my shrink wrap feature is created. I'm getting a doubling up of geometry visible in my graphics area. So a lot of times when I create a shrink wrap feature, I'll end up hiding the skeleton afterwards. Now let's open up the subassembly. And so, just so you can see the geometry, let me unhide the skeleton inside of here. And so when I expand the skeleton, you'll see that it just contains one feature, the shrink wrap feature, but I've got all the necessary reference geometry. At this point, I could assemble components inside of this subassembly, and then I would have the visual references for defining assembly constraints, or if this was used for cabling, routing any cables that I define. And also at this point, I could activate or open the skeleton model and create any other necessary geometry like surfaces or datum features that are needed inside of the skeleton.